Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making Oreo Cheesecake Cupcake. We're starting with our new Breville Sous Chef food processor. And I'll show you just a little bit about it. I don't know a lot about it myself. But up here at the top, we have a food pusher, which is kind of small, but there is a larger one on the outside. Now I'm going to open this up. It's really a little stiff because it's new, but I'll have to take the lid off in order to do my processing. Before I start the processing, I just want to point out that there is an inner bowl that's smaller. And over here, I have my accessories. So I'm sure I don't need all of these, but you can see there are different blades. And there are discs that have different cutting abilities for chopping, for shredding, for julienning. There's a brush here, there's a spatula, everything you might need associated with a food processor. So what I'm going to do is start making the crust of my cupcakes. Actually, it will just be a little bottom area where there's cheesecake over it, so it needs some steadiness, and a crust will do that. I have 1 1/2 packages of Oreo cookies, and I think they're about 39. It looks like 13 in a row times 3, 39, and then half of the package here, which doesn't come out exactly even, but about 58 cookies altogether will go into this large bowl. Unfortunately, it is large. If you don't have a large bowl for your food processor, then just use the smaller one a couple times. So I have them all in there. I'm going to put the lid on. And so I need to line this up and then close it. So we turn it on, it's already plugged in, and that brings up our display, and you'll see there are just some very simple options, and there is a timer. If you choose to use that, you can let it time down for a certain amount of seconds or whatever you want. Now, with my cookies in there, I want to just pulse. This button is lit up like all the others, and it says pulse, so I'm just going to let it go around once or twice and see what happens, and then just keep going until these are finely ground. I just took the lid off and was going to scrape this down with a spatula, and this is fine enough. You might find a few chunks here and there, but I really don't have to do any more processing at this point. I need to remove a third of this. Now, I have looked over at the side here, and there are measurements in cups and in different units, but I can see that there are about 6 cups here, so to take 1/3 of that, I would need about 2 cups. What I have measured out are 2 sticks of butter, and it's cold, came from the refrigerator, and you can see that I've diced it up, and this is to make a little crust. This goes back on. Gets locked into place, and then I'm going to pulse, and I'm going to watch this until it's a nice dough. It's supposed to have a dough consistency. And I think that's about it. I'm going to check on it and we'll see. I would reach in there with my hands, but this is very black. But you can see that it's a little moist as compared to what it was. So that is a nice dough consistency. And what I plan to do with this dough is to make my crust of the cupcakes. I have 2 muffin tins or cupcake tins here that I put papers in, paper liners, and then I have a tablespoon that I'm going to use to go into my dough and get a tablespoon for each one of those 24 wells. You can see that I'm coming down to the bottom of the bowl, and we'll capture that little bit. Measure off 1 tablespoon. I picked up a spoon to help with my measuring spoon, and then you can dig that out with the spoon and let it fall into the paper for your cupcake. And then what we're going to do is, instead of using our hands, although those are fine, you can oil a glass or something that has a bottom that is about the right size and press that down. I've removed the excess dough from this bowl because I'm going to use this bowl to process the filling of our cream cheese cupcakes. And I'll be putting in actually some of the crumbs, so it doesn't matter that this has a little bit of crumb in it already. What I'm going to start with are 2 8-ounce packages of cream cheese, and I've cut it into cubes. For the cream cheese, you may use regular or a low-fat variety if you like. Then add 1 cup of sugar. Next is 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. And then some of those crumbs. We have 2 tablespoons of the crumbs. So we'll just scatter those about, put the lid on, and then process until smooth. And I'm just going to pulse here. And that looks pretty smooth. I'm going to check it. And you can see what it looks like. Let me just get my spatula. Now we're going to add 1/2 cup of whipping cream. Also, a pinch of sea salt and 4 eggs. And I have beaten these lightly. You can just put 1 in at a time if you like and then process them. We're ready to put it in our muffin tins. Now, with the muffin tins, we put our crust in and then we put that in the refrigerator. Here I have my muffin tins and they're nice and chilled. That makes it a little easier to work with and it keeps the batter from penetrating the crust right at the very beginning. So I'm going to take the batter and take an ice cream scoop or something similar to that, and what I want to do is to transfer over to my muffin tin and fill these almost to the top. We have our cupcake pans filled with our batter, and you can see that we come up pretty close to the top on each one, and we have exactly 24. So we're taking these to a 275 degree oven, that's Fahrenheit, and we're going to let it bake for 20 to 22 minutes. Now halfway through the baking, which would be after about 10 minutes, I'm going to turn the pan around so that we can get equal heat on the front and the back. I let the cupcakes bake for 22 minutes altogether, and what we're going to do is turn the oven off, I've already done that, and then leave it open a crack and just wait for it to cool down. And that will minimize the cracking in the top. I've just taken my Oreo cheesecake cupcakes out of the oven. You'll see they look quite different. They have sunk in the center, but expect that to happen as they cool in the oven. Over here, not quite as much. But what we're gonna do is make use of that little valley, and we're going to put those reserved crumbs. We have the Oreo cookie crumbs that we took out at the very beginning after we made them in the food processor. And we have 2 cups of them. I would say just put in what looks right. So we're going to cover all of them. And then after that, we will put them in the refrigerator for about 3 hours. Then they're ready to serve. I have my Oreo cheesecake cupcakes cooled. And I'm going to take a bite. And I would like to say that they're very crumbly on the top. I've got a steak knife here just to help with the demonstration. And you see the little crust on the bottom? It's what we put in there at the very beginning. So you have an entity that looks like that. It's really pretty. Now let me get some space over here and I'll cut down through it and let you see what it looks like. And that bottom crust, you need to actually put some pressure to cut that. Now I'm going to take a bite and let you know what I think. That's luscious. If you like cheesecake at all, and if you like Oreos at all, I think you'll love it. I've enjoyed using the Breville Sous Chef food processor today, making these. It's something new in Betty's kitchen, and a lot of people ask me, where did you get this, where did you get that? You can look at a channel on YouTube, which is called Breville, B-R-E-V-I-L-L-E. And I'll try to put a link to that at the end of this video. Also, if you want to go to their website, it's www.breville.com. And I think you would enjoy seeing all the appliances they have there, not just the food processor, but you'll see it as well as a lot of other things that you're going to want. But I did enjoy doing this, and I hope you enjoyed it too.